So PlantMD is a disease classification app. Simply put, you hold your phone over a plant and it tells you if it's sick or not and what the disease is. So we actually came up with the idea one day just sitting in lunch. Shaza posed the idea of creating an app and I was down, obviously. So we did a little bit of brainstorming and I actually thought about my mom who's always had a passion in gardening. We had moved recently and her garden wasn't doing very well, just it was a new setting. She didn't really know what was up with it. So we ended up making the app and helping my mom out a bit.
Basically how it works is it takes every single pixel of the image and transforms it into an RGB value. And then it compares this array of numbers and then converts it and compares it to other images in the data set to detect any pattern.
So once we got the hard stuff out of the way, like making the app work, we wanted to expand our data set to include more of the things that just helped my mom. So we started implementing new plants. These are the first three that you see up on the board. We started implementing new plants, and TensorFlow actually made us able to do that. It allowed us to be able to input a lot of data and wants to have it all converted.
So the second project I'm going to talk to you about is similar to PlantMD and uses computer vision, but this time for skin conditions. So some of the constraints we worked with for this app is that it had to run completely independently on your phone. So it can't use any servers, have any pulls, or access the internet in any way. It had to run completely independently on the phone, had to be quick, and it had to be really accurate. So it works similarly to PlantMD, but this one can recognize different skin conditions like eczema, blisters, cystic acne, blackheads, whiteheads, all different types of skin conditions that people go through. It was really interesting to solve two completely different problems in the same principles. And so it was really, really unique about how we had a really limited computer science experience and we were able to use TensorFlow.